voices in my head, they counsel me, they understand, they talk to me.
Randy Orton is one of my favorites to paint. He has such a distinctive, iconic look already that I can push things stylistically further with him than I could with maybe some other subjects. He's kind of in that area that I talk about a lot, where if you're going to draw Superman, for instance, you're going to do Superman. But if you're going to do Batman, you can push things a lot further. You know, a lot of people joke like John Cena would be Superman. Randy Orton definitely falls more into that Batman camp, where I can push things further. So we've already got that iconic stance that he does, so I can then push things further with my approach with the paint, where first I had one layer that was just mixing between yellow, orange, and magenta. And then once that dried, I built up with another layer of a darker orange, and then coming in with red here, then I'll do some blue as well as some darker violet to build things up. Now, one of the things with this approach is, you know, I'm building up my layers with the watercolor. That means that I'm having to do those dang tattoos over and over. I even had people asking me about it when I was putting up some progress shots this past week, like, do you enjoy doing those tattoos? Not especially. I'm not a big detail guy, but with someone like Randy, and especially with those really badass tattoos that he has, it's something that I have to get down to really make the finished piece click. And there is that finished piece. Not bad.